Today's Boxing Day, December 26, 2018, and the World Junior Championships are about to get underway here yet again. As this tournament prepares to get underway, I thought I'd prepare a guide for you to give you a prospect-by-prospect breakdown from each of the 31 NHL clubs. So in today's video, I'm going to go through each 31 NHL teams and tell you who's taking part for their prospects in this tournament. And that's coming up next. Hey everyone, and welcome back to another video here at Top Shelf Hockey. If you're new to the channel, thanks for stopping by. We review and discuss all 31 NHL teams as well as international tournaments. So if you're a huge hockey fan, consider subscribing and clicking the bell so you don't miss anything. So as I mentioned, today's December the 26th. The World Junior Championships for the 2019 tournament are about to kick off here. The games are just about to get underway as I sat down to record this video. And I thought there's all kinds of prospects from the NHL in this tournament. And I know each of you out there are kind of rooting for different NHL clubs. So I thought I'd give you a breakdown by rosters here. For each of the 31 NHL teams, who is in this tournament from those respective NHL clubs. Now, before we get underway here, I just want to take a minute here and hope you all had a happy holidays. Of course, yesterday was December the 25th, Christmas Day, and I hope you all had a chance to take some time with your friends and family. Enjoy the great holiday, and I hope Santa Claus was nice to you all. Now, speaking of Santa Claus, he was nice enough and brought me some new studio lighting here for the Top Shelf Hockey set. So we're making our first video with that new lighting here today, so I certainly would love some feedback from you, the viewers, to let me know what you think. So far, because normally I record using mostly natural light, but we now have some studio lighting, have some upgrades here for Christmas, so hopefully things are looking nice here and sounding good. So of course, as always, I'd love some feedback from you to let me know what you think. So now we're going to jump over here to the 31 NHL teams, and I'll give you a breakdown from each team of who's going to be playing in this tournament. Now, the three teams that are going to have the most prospects in this tournament are the Chicago Blackhawks, the Philadelphia Flyers, and the Montreal Canadiens. They each have seven prospects representing their countries in this tournament. So we're going to get started with those clubs. The Chicago Blackhawks have seven players, including three from Team Canada, including defenseman Ian Mitchell and forwards Mackenzie Entwistle and Evan Barrett. Now, Entwistle's luckily going to be starting the tournament here as the 13th forward, but Evan Barrett's been having a tremendous year, and Ian Mitchell as well is going to probably be playing a top four role for Team Canada. So all some big roles here for the Chicago Blackhawks prospects. Of course, two of their bigger name prospects are playing for Team Sweden and Team Finland respectively. 2018 draft pick Adam Boqvist, top defenseman here, likely for Team Sweden. He's going to be one of the more fun players to watch in this tournament as well. Will be representing his country in Sweden. In 2017, first round pick Henri Jokiharju will be playing for Team Finland. Of course, you saw him make his rookie debut with the Hawks this year and had a pretty solid start to his season, but he has been loaned over to Team Finland and will be representing his country. So I do expect big performances out of him. He will be one of the top defenders for Team Finland, playing a big role in logging a lot of minutes for sure. Now the Blackhawks also have 2018 draft pick Filip Kuryshev playing for Switzerland, and they also have defenseman Jakub Galbas representing his country for the Czech Republic, a 2017 draft pick. So all in all, like I said, the Blackhawks have seven prospects in this tournament, one of the top three teams with the most players in this tournament. So lots of hope and lots of help coming to the future of the Chicago Blackhawks here. I know this hasn't been a great season for them here, as well as last, but there is lots of help on the way to kind of get things rejuvenated in Chicago. Now jumping over to the Montreal Canadiens, as I mentioned, they're one of three teams here as well. I have seven prospects. They have a lot of guys in the lineup. A couple of them representing Team Canada. The forward Nick Suzuki, who of course was acquired from the Vegas Golden Knights in the Max Pacioretty trade. Of course, he was a first round pick last year in 2017. And they also have defenseman Josh Brook as well, who's also expected again to play a top four role for Team Canada. So a couple of top players for Team Canada with the Montreal Canadiens affiliation. They have a couple of second round picks from their 2018 picks. Of course, Montreal stockpiled the picks heading into the 2018 draft and had multiple second rounders. They have Jesse Ylönen of Finland and Alex Romanov of Russia, both expected to make their debuts in this tournament here for their countries as well. They have forward Jacob Olsson of Sweden. They also have a couple key players for Team USA, including forward Ryan Poehling, who's a pretty solid two-way player, and goaltender Caden Primo, who was a 2017 seventh-round pick, but really emerged last year as a top goalie playing at Northeastern University, having a pretty solid year again as well. So he very well could turn out to be a draft steal, being a seventh-rounder. Of course, he's the son of former NHL player Keith Primo, and he's certainly expected to play a big role here, meaning lots of time in between the pipes for Team USA. Now, of course, as I mentioned, the other team with seven prospects in this tournament is the Philadelphia Flyers. They have one Canadian, a couple Swedes, and a bunch of Americans representing them in this tournament. Of course, the Canadian player is forward Morgan Frost, who almost made the club at a training camp this year, but ultimately was sent back to junior. Frost is certainly going to be playing a top six role for Canada. I mean, he can play center ice, but he's probably going to be playing a fair bit on the wing in this tournament, and his playmaking skills are certainly going to be put to good use for Team Canada for sure. I do expect him to be one of their more productive forwards. As I mentioned, they also have a couple of Swedish players, including defenseman Adam Ginning and goaltender Samuel Ersson. Now, the Flyers also have four players representing Team USA in this tournament, including a couple of first-round picks from the 2018 draft, and that's forwards Joel Farabee and Jay O'Brien, both expected to play a fairly big role. Farabee likely going to get some playing time with Jack Hughes, so I do expect Farabee to play probably a higher, bigger role than O'Brien, but O'Brien's certainly pretty creative, offensively gifted hockey player in his own right, and likely will be a key component as well for Team USA. They also have forward Noah Cates and defenseman Jack St. Ivani. So the Flyers, again, like I said, with the Habs and the Hawks, are certainly the most stacked teams in this tournament, so all kinds of prospects on display. So fans of those teams, I do give you an opportunity here to get a look into the future and to see how well these prospects have progressed since their draft year and see how they match up well against other players of similar age and skill level. Now next up, we have a couple of teams with six prospects in this tournament, and those are the Boston Bruins and the Vegas Golden Knights. So they're both also well represented in this tournament. Let's get started here with the Boston Bruins, who have players from a variety of countries, including Canada, forward Jack Studnicka as well, who's likely going to be playing more of a bottom six role for Canada. Now they also have defenseman Urho Vaakanainen, who you've seen in the NHL this season. Unfortunately, Vaakanainen's season was kind of in danger early on when he suffered a concussion, but has been recovering fine and will represent Team Finland here in the tournament. They also have goaltender Kyle Kaiser, who, along I mentioned with Caden Primo, is going to be mainly the two main goaltenders here for Team USA between the pipes. They are carrying a third goaltender in Spencer Knight, who's also a draft-eligible goalie for the 2019 draft, and is probably one of the more prominent goaltenders in the 2019 draft as well. So the Americans are certainly in good shape when it comes to goaltending. The Bruins have Russian forward Pavel Shen in this tournament representing Russia. They also have two Czech players, including defenseman Daniel Bukac and forward Jakub Lukau. So as I mentioned, the Vegas Golden Knights also have six prospects in this tournament, and the six prospects are going to be comprising of five different countries, the most prominent being forward Cody Glass of Team Canada, who's likely going to be their top center, playing a lot of important minutes in a lot of important situations. Cody Glass has really shone this year, his leadership is coming through, and he's expected to play a huge role for Team Canada. They also have defenseman Erik Brännström, who's going to be representing Sweden. Brännström's certainly going to be one of the more fun players to watch in this tournament. He's a very crafty, mobile defenseman, expected to play a big role for Sweden. They also have forward Lukas Elvin, also from Sweden as well. The Golden Knights have forward Ivan Morozov, representing Team Russia. They also have Czech Republic goaltender Yuri Patera, and Denmark forward Jonas Rønberg, representing themselves here in this tournament. So again, Vegas, like Boston, has six prospects all together in this tournament. Lots of good help coming along the way for Vegas, but none more important than forward Cody Glass. Next up, with five prospects in this tournament, we have the LA Kings. Now, of course, the Kings are not having a very good year as well, near the bottom of the NHL, so they do have some good help along the way. And of course, one of the Kings prospects, Gabe Vilardi for Team Canada, will not be participating. Unfortunately, he's been battling injuries quite a bit, really, ever since he's been drafted. Hopefully, he can get that rectified and looked after and get his career back on track. But there's certainly a lot of concern over Vilardi and the back problems he's been having. But unfortunately, we won't see him in this tournament representing Team Canada. Although the LA Kings also have two other players representing Team Canada in this tournament, including defenseman Marcus Phillips and forward Jared Anderson-Dolan. Now, Anderson-Dolan was also named one of the alternate captains. Also went into the training camp for Team Canada here with a bit banged up, but he's been able to come through it. He had a wrist injury and he seems to be okay and is expected to play here on opening night. Now, the LA Kings also have the captain of Team USA in their prospect pool, that's defenseman Mikey Anderson. So, Anderson was a 2017 draft pick, obviously showing lots of leadership skills. Team USA happy to slap the C on his chest for this tournament. They also have their 2018 first-round pick representing Finland, and that's Rasmus Kupari. Kupari, again, should be one of the top forwards for Finland, and a fun Finnish team to watch. Now, Finland sometimes can be a little bit underrated. It's a team like Sweden you can never take lightly. They always are very competitive and are always a dangerous team no matter who they're playing. Rounding out the Kings prospects, they have Swedish forward Johan Södergren representing his country as well. There's many NHL teams with four prospects, so let's go through those because that's going to be the bulk of our list here today. Getting started with the New York Rangers, obviously they've got a variety of all four players from different countries, including Russian prospect Vitali Krasov, who they grabbed high in the first round in the 2018 NHL draft. Surprised by many people that he was able to go so high in the draft, but the Rangers are obviously very high in his prospect. And if you haven't had a chance to watch him and to see why the Rangers were so excited to draft him, then you have an opportunity here to watch him play for Team Russia in the World Junior Championships. Now they also have a couple of defensemen, including Swedish defenseman Nils Lundqvist and Switzerland defenseman Nico Gross. Rounding out the Rangers prospect pool is a third defenseman playing for Team USA, and that's Keandre Miller, who again was a pretty high draft pick last year in the 2018 draft. Miller is certainly a very fun defenseman to watch and will play one of the bigger roles on the blue line for Team USA. The Toronto Maple Leafs are another team with four prospects playing in this tournament, including goaltender Ian Scott, who's expected to probably be the backup goaltender for Team Canada, but you never know. Between him and Mikey DiPietro, they're both going to probably get equal playing time early on and see if one looks better than the other. Scott's certainly a very capable goaltender, having a tremendous season right now. So even though it's expected that DiPietro will be the starter once we get to the playoff rounds, if he faults at all or Scott is outshining him in the preliminary games, would not be surprised to see him get more time. So again, a very solid prospect there for Toronto, representing Team Canada. Now, they also have forward Pontus Holmberg representing Team Sweden, as well as defenseman Rasmus Sandin, who was a 2018 first-round pick of theirs, playing for Team Sweden as well. Now, unfortunately, the other Maple Leafs Swedish defender, Timothy Lilgren, will not be at this tournament. He unfortunately had to withdraw due to injury, so I know as a player Team Sweden was hoping to have in their lineup, but unfortunately that will not happen. Otherwise, the Leafs would have had five prospects going in the tournament. Technically, he made the team, just not able to go due to injury. They also have Czech Republic defenseman Filip Kral as the rounding out of the prospects here for the Toronto Maple Leafs. So again, the Leafs have lots of good prospects in this tournament as well. Now, the Detroit Red Wings are another team here with four prospects, including a couple of first-round picks from 2018, both representing Team Canada. That's center Joe Valino, who could also be playing on the wing for Team Canada. Obviously, Joe Valino dropped down in the 2018 draft and unfortunately did not go as high as many people expected him to go, but still a bit of a draft steal by the Red Wings, in my opinion, and we'll see what he can do here for Team Canada. They've also got defenseman Jarrett McIsaac of the Halifax Mooseheads, who is making this roster for Team Canada as well. But it looks as though for the first game, at least tonight, when Canada gets underway, it looks as though he may be the seventh defenseman and won't be seeing a lot of playing time, but he's still very capable of jumping in there. I think they're just kind of going with a little bit more of the older defenseman to kind of start the tournament, see where it goes. But McIsaac's certainly very capable of jumping in at any time. Of course, they've also got Czech Republic player Filip Zadina, who could be one of the more exciting players to watch in this tournament. And again, like Valino and McIsaac kind of fell down in the draft a little bit, the Red Wings certainly had a fairly solid 2018 draft, in my opinion. And all three of these guys that they got early on are all going to be showcasing here their talents and see what's coming for the future of the Red Wings. Now, they've also got Danish forward Melty Svetkov as well, rounding out their group of four prospects in this tournament. Now, the Vancouver Canucks are another team with four prospects, including the Team Canada starting goaltender Mikey DiPietro. Like I said, along with Ian Scott, they make up the goaltending tandem here for Team Canada. It's widely expected DiPietro will be the starter, but again, like I said, Scott's certainly very capable as well, so I think Canada is in good hands in goal. Of course, they got all-star defenseman Quinn Hughes, who is expected to be a top player in the tournament, as well as for Team USA. The Hughes brothers will be very fun to watch and be on display here. Of course, his brother Jack's expected to go number one overall in the 2019 NHL draft. Of course, he's not yet affiliated to an NHL team, but Quinn Hughes has had a tremendous showing here and will be one of the more fun players to watch for Team USA for sure. Joining Hughes on Team USA for the Vancouver Canucks prospects is third-round pick from last year, Tyler Madden. They also have defenseman Tony Yutinen representing Team Finland. Now, the Calgary Flames are another team with four prospects in this tournament, many of them playing for Team Slovakia. The group of three playing for Team Slovakia include Adam Rzeszka, Milos Roman, and Martin Papasil. Rounding out their group of four is Swedish forward Filip Svenningsson. Also joining the group of teams with four prospects in this tournament is the Buffalo Sabres. Of course, one of the top prospects for the Sabres in this tournament is defenseman for Team USA, Mattias Samuelsson. Of course, Samuelsson is of heritage of the U.S. and Sweden, but has always represented USA on the international scale here. So Samuelsson will suit up for Team USA in this tournament. They also have Czech Republic forward Matej Pekar. A couple of Finns in this tournament, including the goaltender for Finland, Ukko-Pekka Laukkanen, and defenseman Oskari Laaksonen. Another team here with four prospects in this tournament is the Anaheim Ducks, including the captain for Team Canada, Maxime Comtois. Of course, you saw Comtois early on in the NHL season playing for the Ducks. Had a pretty good start to his rookie season, but ultimately they decided to send him back to junior, and he's going to be playing a significant role for Canada, not only on the ice, but off the ice as well, being the captain and leader of that team. Of course, they've also got Swedish player Isaac Lundström, who also started the year in Anaheim and has also gone back here to play for his country in this tournament. We're also going to see a couple of goaltending prospects for the Ducks on display in this tournament, including Swedish goaltender Olli Eriksson Ek and Czech Republic goaltender Lukas Dostal. Another team with four prospects in this tournament is the New York Islanders. Of course, one of their top prospects in this tournament will be playing the blue line for Team Canada, and then it's defenseman Noah Dobson. Of course, they've also got sniper Oliver Wallstrom representing Team USA. Both of those players were first-round picks in the 2018 NHL draft and are big parts of their future going forward. They also have American forward Logan Cockerill on the roster, who was a 2017 draft pick. Another goaltender from the Czech Republic, Jakub Skerb, who's also expected to play a big role for the Czech Republic in this tournament and likely could steal some games in their favor. Now, another team with four prospects in this tournament is the New Jersey Devils, including Ty Smith, who's expected to play a top four role for Team Canada. He's going to be a big part of that Canadian blue line. Of course, Ty Smith was a 2018 first-round selection of the New Jersey Devils. They also have Finnish forward Aaron Ylivedi, Swedish forward Fabian Zetterlin, and Swiss goaltender Akira Schmid. So that rounds out your group of four prospects for the Devils in this tournament. Now, the last team with four prospects in the 2019 World Junior Championships is the Columbus Blue Jackets. They have two players from Team Russia, including 2017 draft pick goaltender Daniil Tarasov and forward Kirill Marchenko. They also have 2017 selection from Sweden forward Emil Bengtsson. They also have 2018 selection defenseman from Switzerland Tim Berney. We have four NHL teams with three prospects in this tournament. That group includes the Avalanche, the Oilers, the Jets, and the Florida Panthers. The Colorado Avalanche have forward Shane Bowers, who's likely going to play a bottom six role for Team Canada. Of course, Bowers was originally drafted by the Ottawa Senators and was obtained in a trade that sent Matt Duchene over to Ottawa. They've also got forward Martin Kaut, who's likely going to be one of the top forwards for the Czech Republic as well, likely getting a chance to play with Filip Zadina. Kaut's certainly a prospect you're going to want to keep a close eye on. He will be playing a big role and is likely playing on one of the top lines in the tournament. 2018 selection from Russia playing defense, Dmyla Zermilov. Now, the Florida Panthers, even though they only have three prospects in this tournament, they're all top-notch prospects, including Owen Tippett, who's going to be playing first-line minutes for Team Canada. Tippett is a natural goal scorer, big-time sniper, and is expected to play a large role for Canada in this tournament. Of course, they've also got Aleksi Heponiemi playing a big role for Finland. Of course, he played some junior hockey over in Canada in the Western Hockey League. Absolutely tore it up, was putting up a ton of points, but opted to go back and play in Europe here before making his NHL debut. He likely does that with Florida next year. They also have their 2018 first-round pick in this tournament, Russian forward Grigory Denisenko, playing for Team Russia. So, obviously, he's going to be another player to watch. So, even though the Panthers only have three players in this tournament, they're all top-notch prospects and a big part of the Panthers' future. Now, as I mentioned, the Edmonton Oilers are another team with three players in this tournament, including defenseman Evan Bouchard, who was their 2018 first-round selection, was a high pick to the Oilers this year, a big mobile puck-moving defenseman playing for the London Knights in the OHL, having another terrific season since he's been returned to junior. Didn't look too bad in the NHL to start the year as well, got his first NHL goal, and he's expected to be playing top pair minutes for Canada at this tournament. They also have their 2017 second-round pick defenseman for Team USA, Phil Kemp, and 2017 third-round selection, a Russian defenseman, Dmitry Samarkov. Last team here with three prospects in this tournament is the Winnipeg Jets. One of their top players in this tournament prospects is going to be defenseman Dylan Sandberg for Team USA, certainly playing a big role, getting a lot of top 4 minutes for sure on that US blue line. They also have their second round pick from the 2018 draft, Swedish forward David Gustafsson in the tournament. They also have their 2017 fourth round pick from Finland in the tournament as well, and that's forward Santeri Virtanen. Now we have a bunch of teams as well with only two prospects, including the Washington Capitals, who have defenseman Alex Alexiev, who's been playing his junior hockey in Canada in the Western Hockey League for Red Deer. It was a little bit of a draft steal, in my opinion. He went lower than many people give him credit for, but he had some, a lot of different personal things going on last year, but he will be playing a big role for the Russian blue line. And they also have Slovakian defenseman Martin Verheri, who is also a 2018 selection of the Washington Capitals. The Dallas Stars have two prospects in this tournament, including forward Jason Robertson, who's going to be playing a pretty significant role for Team USA in the forward group. I have Swedish forward Oscar Bock also playing for Team Sweden. Of course, the Nashville Predators also have two players in this tournament, including forward Elli Tolvanen of Team Finland. Now, Tolvanen certainly should be one of the top players in this tournament. He's got a lot of international experience. Played in the Olympics last year, had a record-breaking season in the KHL as well, and so far hadn't really caught on full-time, at least with the Nashville Predators, so he has been loaned over to play for Team Finland. And they also have their 2018 fourth-round pick from the Czech Republic, Jakub Kondolek. Carolina Hurricanes also have two prospects in this tournament, but they're both pretty significant pieces. They have USA forward Jack Drury, as well as Czech Republic forward Martin Nikash. So Nikash is at one point was expected to make this team out of training camp. I thought he might pair well with newly drafted Andrei Svechnikov. Unfortunately, that hasn't quite worked out just yet. But of course, you put Nikash along with players like Martin Kaut and Filip Zadina, and that Czech Republic team is going to be pretty fun to watch. The Arizona Coyotes are the last team here with two prospects, including center iceman Barrett Hayton, who's likely going to be playing probably a middle six role for Team Canada. He'll likely be paired up with fellow Sault Ste. Marie Greyhound teammate Morgan Frost of the Philadelphia Flyers organization. Those two players likely will play well. They're quite familiar with each other. But Barrett Hayton was another player in the 2018 draft who certainly went higher than projected. The Coyotes kind of went off the board to grab him, which is another reason why Zadina dropped down to the Red Wings. But again, another player for Team Canada kind of getting his feet wet here at this tournament. And of course, the Coyotes also have a 2017 pick defenseman from Sweden, Philip Westerlund. Now, of course, there are a few teams with only one representation at this tournament, including the Ottawa Senators, who have American forward Josh Norris. Now, of course, Norris was originally drafted by the San Jose Sharks and was traded over to Ottawa in that big Erik Karlsson trade we saw at the beginning of NHL training camp. The Pittsburgh Penguins also only have one prospect in this tournament, and that's Swedish forward Philip Hallander, who was a 2018 draft selection. And the St. Louis Blues are another team with only one prospect in this tournament, but he's expected to play a major role for Team Russia, and that's captain and forward Klim Kostin. And of course, Kostin was a 2017 draft selection. This will be his last year of eligibility for this tournament. He likely becomes a full-time member of the Blues roster here over time, likely into next year. But Kostin's going to be a major player for Team Russia. Now, the San Jose Sharks are the final team here with only one prospect, and that's forward Sasha Chmelevskiy. Chmelevskiy is expected to play a bottom six role for Team USA. Now, of course, that means we haven't covered all 31 NHL teams. There are a few teams here that do not have any representation at this tournament. That includes the Tampa Bay Lightning and the Minnesota Wild. So it's not good news for Minnesota. Now, in Tampa's case, they have all kinds of prospects, a very deep prospect pool, but many of them are already playing either in the NHL or at the AHL level, and they're just kind of beyond the eligibility for this tournament. Of course, this is an under 20 tournament, so once you turn 20 years of age, you're no longer eligible. So the Tampa Bay Lightning and Minnesota Wild, unfortunately, if you're a fan of those teams, you don't have any players to watch in this tournament. As I mentioned before, the tournament is a fantastic way to see a lot of the future NHL top players in action. There's all kinds of guys, not only the ones I mentioned, but there's other players expected to be top picks in the 2019 draft as well as 2020. As I mentioned, of course, Team USA, Jack Hughes, expected to go number one overall. You got Kaapo Kakko for Finland, who's expected to go number two and is trying to rival himself into that number one overall conversation for the 2019 draft as well. And of course, you got a Team Canada player, Alexis Lafreniere, who's expected to go number one overall in 2020. So the future of the NHL will be on display in this tournament. I highly recommend you taking as much of the action as you can. So I hope this guide helps you break down all the prospects by NHL team so you can see who's representing their teams in this tournament. If you're new to the channel here, hope you consider subscribing. We cover all 31 NHL teams as well as international tournaments. So if you're new, hit that subscribe button. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up before you go. I'd appreciate it if you did. As always, thank you very much for watching, everybody. We will catch you next time.